We're going to talk about how to prepare for a good night's sleep. One out of three Americans has sleep issues today, and perhaps you're one of them. Or perhaps you just want to maximize your sleep because you know a good night's sleep is the foundation of looking your best the next day and feeling your best. In fact, research has shown that the body heals itself in a very profound way during sleep, including our brain. So if you want to be the sharpest that you can be tomorrow, get good sleep tonight. Now, interestingly, Ayurveda has known many secrets about optimal sleep for thousands of years that are just now being validated by modern research. I wanted to share some of those with you today. They're not all totally well known, and I think you'll find some tips that can really make a difference for you. So first of all, I'd like to just say how we prepare for good night's sleep actually starts when we get up in the morning. So some of the secrets of a good night's sleep in our morning routine are actually to try to get outside and get some exposure to some morning light, ideally for at least 20 minutes. This helps suppress the melatonin in the morning so we're most alert during the day, and it actually has an effect to increase and support good melatonin production, our sleep hormone, that night so we can actually get sounder sleep. Also, just a little tip on that, people who get at least 20 minutes of morning sunlight actually have better metabolism and they tend to weigh less, even if they're eating the same as other people, the same number of calories, and they're actually sleeping the same. So that's another tip. It might actually help you lose a few pounds. So the next thing is that our main meal should be at noon, at least a really full meal. I recommend that people have at least half their plate of cooked vegetables at lunchtime, because when you get that balance of all those tastes in your diet at lunch, especially the vegetables, you feel much more satisfied all day and you don't end up coming home from work with ravenous appetite and starting to stuff things in your mouth before you've even planned dinner, and then you eat dinner on top of it, and then you have to digest that while you sleep. And that's a recipe for disrupted sleep, as well as not cleaning your body or your brain very well because it's busy digesting the meal rather than getting rid of waste from the day. So start with a good lunch, and when you get home, try to leave work at work. If you have a dog, it's a great time to walk the dog, and I would recommend don't listen to the news while you're walking your dog on your phone. Just enjoy nature. Try to get away from the electronic stimulation. Breathe, look at the trees, breathe the fresh air, just kind of enjoy, interact with your dog. Just be simple, because getting the mind out of that over-connectedness that we have today with electronic devices and too much information and processing, we want to get our brain to shift into a mode of kind of easier function. That's going to be a good preparation for sleep. Sometimes people like to meditate at the end of the day or do yoga, and both of those are fabulous activities to transition from that intense, more mental work, which most people have at their jobs today, to a more relaxed evening. Another tip is for dinner to be not too much and not too little. So when you've had a bigger meal at lunch, you can eat lighter food, like especially cooked food, cooked vegetables. A soup is considered in Ayurveda to be the best evening meal. It can be a very hearty soup. You can have chickpeas in it or lentils and vegetables and all sorts of flavors and spices. That warm, full feeling that you get will satisfy you, but it won't overload your digestive tract, like having, you know, a baked potato and a big piece of meat, or even a big salad. We think of salad as light, but Ayurveda tells us it's so rough, cold, and crunchy that it can create disturbance in the digestive tract, like a little gas, bloating, or too much peristalsis that can disturb the depth of our sleep. So that hot, warm, hearty soup or some cooked vegetables will be ideal. Cooked grains, if you have to have something non-vegetarian at night, then have like the Chinese way. You have small pieces, say, of chicken in a stir fry, or something in a soup. That would be the most easy to digest. Also, light has a big impact on us. So around 8 o'clock to 9 o'clock, that's when our melatonin starts to be secreted. It's suppressed by light, however, especially blue light. So want to get off our devices, or at the very least, change to settings which make the screen more orange. You can also dim the lights in your house so you're not not like daylight. And you can also put on blue blocker glasses if you're into it. Those are orange colored glasses that really block all the blue rays, so you're not suppressing melatonin. Now, having tried all those things myself and getting feedback from patients, I would say that they're all help. But if you end up staying up late, like after 10 on your computer or till 11 or so, and you, even though you're wearing those glasses, all that intense mental work will probably still disturb your sleep. So Ayurveda recommends we wind down at that time too. If you did check your email or something, try to get off of that about an hour before you're going to go to bed, maybe by 9, 9:30. And transition to doing the dishes, again, some simple activity, talking with your family members, just straightening up, getting organized for the next day. Sometimes making a list of the things you have to do the next day will leave your mind free when you actually lie down and put your head on the pillow. You're not obsessing about trying to remember all the things you have to do the next day. So Ayurveda also recommends that we skip the alcohol at night, or at least limit it to a very small amount if you're going to have alcohol, because in the long run, a recent review of 27 studies show that sleep is not actually improved by drinking alcohol. And I know that a lot of my patients who have had sleep problems have turned to drinking something alcoholic in the evening, and they say, well, it helps me go to sleep. It may help you go to sleep, the research shows, but by the second half of the night, when the body switches into REM sleep, it tends to disturb that, and it tends to disrupt and cause a less deep sleep later in the night. So ultimately, you can end up being sleep deprived, even though you thought you slept more. So Ayurveda would say, if you want to have something before sleep, especially if you maybe had a light dinner, and maybe you, some people actually will wake up kind of hungry, or they're going to bed and they feel a little empty or hungry, then have a little hot boiled milk or a milk substitute. Warm is better, so it's very soothing to the gut. And you could put a pinch of cardamom and turmeric in it, and or saffron, or even ground white poppy seeds. Those natural white poppy seeds actually do have an effect to calm the mind. And ashwagandha also, withania somnifera. Somnifera actually means sleep. It's an herb that's very calming to the brain and the nervous system, and very calming for the adrenal system, our stress handling system as well. So ashwagandha is a fabulous herb to add to your hot milk at night. So if you also enjoy taking an herb, or you're looking for a supplement at night, I generally recommend people look to the Ayurvedic herbs, because they tend not to be habit forming. Ones that contain valerian root tend to help people fall asleep more quickly. We say trouble falling asleep is a vata kind of sleep problem due to an unsettled nervous system. And the Indian valerian is very calming, and combined with other herbs like the ashwagandha in a product such as Blissful Sleep helps people to get to sleep. And deep rest is the formula for people who tend to wake up in the middle of the night. That's due to more activation of pitta, or metabolism. So again, not eating too much at night is a good start to avoid that. And also having herbs at night, like the cabbage rose, the amla berry in this formula, shatavari or Indian asparagus root. These are all very cooling, and they calm the emotional part of our brain, which, as you might have noticed, sometimes you'll wake up in the middle of the night if you're worried about something or something was upsetting to you. So this helps to calm that part of our brain so we can get a good night's sleep. So I hope that you find these tips helpful, and I hope that they will help you to get a great night's sleep and awaken your power to heal. This is Dr. Nancy Lonsdorf.